Good morning. Today's UG clinics is about angled logic glaucoma and the secondary glaucomas. So firstly, discussing about the primary angled logic glaucoma. So this angled logic term, it refers to the occlusion of the trabecular meshwork by the peripheral iris. So by this, when we go to the definition of the primary angle closure glaucoma, we can say that it is characterized by the apposition of the peripheral iris against the trabecular meshwork, resulting in the obstruction of the aqueous outflow due to already closed angle. So the primary angle closure disease is classified as primary angle closure suspect, primary angle closure, and primary angle closure glaucoma. If the cause is due to the anatomically predisposed eye, then the cause is primary, or if it is due to any other ocular or the systemic factor, then the cause is secondary. So the classification of this primary angle closure disease is given by the International Glaucoma Societies. If we go by the definition, the primary angle closure glaucoma is synonymous to the chronic primary angle closure glaucoma, and the diagnosis is made by iridotrabecular contact of more than 270 degrees on gonioscopy, and peripheral anterior synechiae are formed, and IOP is constantly elevated, and the optic disc shows the glaucomatous damage, and the visual fields show glaucomatous defects. So here, the primary angle closure glaucoma simply can be of optic disc changes and visual field defects with raised IOP. The pathogenesis of the disease can be divided into three types, that is pupillary block mechanism, phacomorphic mechanism, and plateau iris configuration. For pupillary block mechanism, the precipitating factors can be physiological mydriasis, that is reading in a dim light or watching TV in the dark room, or it can be the anxiety or the emotional stress. The pharmacological mydriasis can be induced by the mydriatic such as phenylephrine or tropicamide or cyclopentylate, homotropin or atropine, or it can be the bronchodilators or antidepressants or vasoconstrictors. The pharmacological meiosis can be introduced by ecothyroid and pilocarpine. There is a plateau iris mechanism which is also called as angle closure glaucoma without pupillary block. In this, insertion of the iris anteriorly on the ciliary body or the displacement of the ciliary body anteriorly, opposition of the peripheral iris with the trabecular meshwork causes plateau iris configuration. The symptoms of the primary angle closure glaucoma includes eye pain, one-sided headache, redness of the eye, and seeing the colored halos. The colored halos are the rainbows which are seen around the objects, and there can be episodes of unilateral transient blurring of vision on one side, and nausea or vomiting, and rapidly progressive impairment of vision, photophobia, and lacrimation. The primary angle closure glaucoma manifests as subacute, acute, or the chronic forms. The subacute form is characterized by an attack of transient rise of IOP, which may last for a few minutes to 1 to 2 hours. Precipitating factors can be physiological mydriasis, physiological shallowing of the anterior chamber after lying in the prone position, or pharmacological mydriasis following use of pupil dilating drugs. Symptoms will include episode of unilateral transient blurring of vision, colored halos, self-termination of the attack can occur. And signs can be the eye is usually white and it is not congested. In the acute, the primary angle closure glaucoma, the attack is usually precipitated with primary angle closure, which may be due to the pupillary block because of sudden closure of the angle. The clinical features will be including the pain, which is typical in the acute attack, and it is characterized by sudden onset of very severe pain along the distribution of the fifth nerve. Nausea, vomiting, prostrations can be seen along with the pain. There will be rapidly progressive diminution of vision, redness, photophobia, lacrimation. There can be past history of attacks similarly, and the signs will be including the lids may be edematous as shown in the right side figure. The conjunctiva is chemosed and congested, and the cornea becomes edematous as we are seeing in the picture, and the anterior chamber is very shallow and the angle of the anterior chamber is completely lost as we are seeing in the gonioscopy, and this classification can be given by Schaffer's grading, and the iris may be discolored and pupil is semi-dilated, IOP is markedly elevated, and optic disc is edematous and hyperemic if we are seeing the posterior segment,
and the fellow eye has a shallow anterior chamber and occludable angle. The treatment from the angle closure glaucoma includes first the IOP lowering agents, which is the medical therapy and definitive therapy and prophylaxis of the fellow eye. Firstly, the immediate medical therapy to lower the IOP includes systemic hyperosmotic agents such as intravenous mannitol, which is given 1 gram per kg body weight, and systemic carbonic anhydrase inhibitors can be given, that is esterazolamide 500 mg IV stat or 250 mg tablets 3 times a day. Topical anti-glaucoma drugs can be instilled immediately, which includes the beta blockers, alpha adrenergic agonists, pilocarpine, prostaglandin analogs, and analgesics, antiemetics have to be given along with these. Compressive gonioscopy with 4 mirror goniolens can be helpful. Topical steroids are usually given. The definitive therapy here is the laser peripheral iridotomy. The laser peripheral iridotomy should always be preferred over the surgical PI. And filtration surgeries such as trabeculectomy should be usually performed when the IOP cannot be controlled with the maximum medical therapy. Next, coming to the absolute primary angle closure glaucoma. If the primary angle closure glaucoma is untreated, then gradually it passes to the final phase, which is absolute glaucoma. Here the clinical features includes painful blind eye, which is the eye is painful, irritable, and completely blind, where there is no perception of light, and perilimbal reddish hue blue zone, which includes slight ciliary flush around the cornea due to the dilated anterior ciliary vessels. Caput medusae is the few prominent and enlarged vessels seen along in the long-standing cases. Cornea in the early stages becomes clear, but as the slowly progresses, it becomes hazy. The anterior chamber is very shallow, iris becomes atrophic, pupil becomes fixed and dilated, and optic disc shows the glaucomatous optic atrophy changes. Intraocular pressure is high and eyeball becomes stony hard. The management of such case of absolute glaucoma includes retrobulbar alcohol injection, destruction of the secretory ciliary epithelium of the by cryotherapy, and enucleation of the eyeball. The complications will include corneal ulceration, staphyloma formation, which includes the ciliary staphyloma and the equatorial staphyloma, and atrophic bulbi. The next topic is the secondary glaucomas, and the secondary glaucomas occurs because of different etiologies, and the classification is given here. And first, it may be included in the pigmentary glaucoma or the neovascular glaucoma. Pseudo exfoliation syndrome will lead to the secondary glaucomas, and a uveitis which also leads to the secondary glaucomas, which includes the glaucomatocyclitis, Fuchs heterochromatic uveitis, and the infectious causes and steroid related causes, lens related causes such as phacolytic glaucoma, lens particle glaucoma, phacoanaphylactic glaucoma. The traumatic glaucoma can also be seen, and that includes the angle recession, there will be formation of hyphema, Gosell traumatic glaucoma, and Schwartz glaucoma. The left sided picture here shows the glaucoma types in the upper figure and the healthy eyes in the lower figure. The glaucomatous types, the first one is the inflammatory glaucoma, which develops because of the inflammatory process which occurs in the eye. The second one is the neovascular glaucoma, in which there is development of the new vessels on the iris, which leads to the neovascular glaucoma. This neovascular glaucoma is also called as rubeosus iridis or the 100-ray glaucoma. The third picture here shows the traumatic glaucoma, and the traumatic glaucoma can be occurring because of different mechanisms such as the blunt trauma, and the inflammatory glaucoma because it can lead to the traumatic glaucoma, and glaucoma due to intraocular hemorrhage, and lens induced glaucoma due to ruptured, swollen and dislocated lens, angle closure due to the peripheral anterior synechiae, and epithelial or fibrous growth which may involve the trabeculum. Angle recession glaucoma refers to the rupture of the ciliary body. Unilateral open angle glaucoma usually occurs after the years of the blunt trauma. Angle recession is not the cause of the glaucoma, but just it is an indicator of an old trauma. The second picture here shows the phacomorphic glaucoma, which is because of the lens which has the intumescent cataract. The intermittent cataract will be pushing the iris forward and obliterates the angle, resulting in the secondary acute angle closure glaucoma, which will be causing the increased iridoreticular contact. And the third one is showing the phacolytic glaucoma. The phacolytic glaucoma is a type of secondary open angle glaucoma in which the trabecular meshwork is clogged with the lens proteins, macrophages, which are phagocytosed by the lens proteins. Usually in this condition, there will be features of acute congestive glaucoma. Anterior chamber becomes deep and aqueous may contain pseudo-hypopyon and as shown in this picture, and then the anterior chamber is open on gonioscopy. Usually the medical management of this will include the medical therapy, extraction of the hypermature cataractous lens by PCIOL implantation. Glaucomas can also occur because of different other causes, and the other cause of the lens induced glaucoma is lens particle glaucoma and phacoantigenic glaucoma. Lens particle glaucoma is a secondary glaucoma in which the trabecular meshwork is blocked by the lens particles themselves, unlike that of the phacolytic glaucoma in which the macrophages will clog the trabecular meshwork. Phacoantigenic glaucoma occurs in this condition. There will be fulminating acute inflammatory reaction due to the antigen antibody reaction. Mechanism of rise of IOP and its management is similar to that of the acute inflammatory glaucomas. As we came to the end of the session, there is the questionnaire at the end of the session. And the first question is, what are the diagnostic criteria for the primary angle closure glaucoma? Second question is, how does a patient with acute PACG presents? Third question is, what is absolute glaucoma? Fourth question is, what are the types of lens-induced glaucoma? Fifth question is, what is neovascular glaucoma? All the questions are to be answered. Thank you.